Hi, my name is Matilde Miranda, and I'm at UCLA. I'm a first-year graduate student in the Molecular Biology Interdepartmental Program. I'm currently studying Cell and Developmental Biology. I'm in Bridget Gomperts' lab, where we study lung disease and lung cancer. Lung cancer is very deadly, so we've developed a model here in the lab that mimics what humans develop later on in life as a result of genetic disease or from smoking. And what my project entails is seeing how the lung cancer model is similar or different to what we find in real life, and how different types of cancer that we're seeing in our samples affect different types of lung cancers seen in humans. So I'm from the Bay Area. I'm originally from Fremont, and I did my undergraduate at San Francisco State University, and I graduated in 2014. I grew up learning about science from television shows like Bill Nye the Science Guy, which proves science can be fun. And when I got older, not only do I see science can be fun, but it can be something that anyone can do. So as a woman, and especially as a minority in science, I want to be able to show that there are people like me and that I can inspire a younger generation to go ahead and study science, get started early, and make a difference in the world. I've always held an interest in science, but it really wasn't until my undergraduate career that I was exposed to laboratory research. As a sophomore, I was able to become part of a lab and did hands-on research and had my own project. And I really liked the interactiveness that science has to offer. I'm motivated to do science because I want to make a difference. I want to bring hope to not only myself, but also to my family members and friends who have unfortunately been afflicted by diseases that sometimes don't have a cure. And while research is a slow process, it does give hope for a cure in the future. My project in the Gomperts Lab is studying lung cancer, and we've developed a lung cancer model that may closely resemble what is seen in humans. So my project is specifically identifying what different types of cancer are seen in this lung cancer model. The way I work on my experiment is that I first need to treat the tissue and dehydrate it. This means that it's easier for me to get the antibodies present in the tissue exposed to the environment. So I put them through a series of alcohol washes, and then I use a microwave which boils the tissue, which is able to expose the antigens present in this lung cancer. I then am able to get antibodies that are very sensitive to light, which is why we keep them in a refrigerator, and I'm able to put them onto the tissue, and then I can incubate them at a cold temperature so that the antibodies are able to bind to any antigens, any signals that are present into the tissue. So after the tissue has been processed, one very important step is outlining the samples. This allows us to keep any fluids, be it antibodies or wash buffer, in the sample. So I'm able to take a wax pen and I outline just the periphery of these samples in order to minimize the amount of antibodies that we use, but also keep a central location of where these solutions are going to be put onto the slide. Lab life is very much a team effort. A lab is like an office. You have a team, each person has a responsibility, but when you come together, you can make something amazing happen. My hopes and dreams are that this lung cancer model is able to serve the population and provide a basis for disease modeling, or perhaps even for drug screening that allows for finding a cure to devastating lung cancer. Research allows me to express my creativity, and I want to keep doing this for not only the remainder of my PhD, but also in the future. So I would like to see myself working in a lab, but also spreading the fun to the general public. I want to get the message of how science is going to benefit humankind out to the public. When I first started doing scientific research, it was a little hard at first, but what I was able to find was that in an environment where you are going to be exploring how your creativity, you're going to be able to bring your imagination to life, you're solving problems, you're asking, you are the boss. And so what I have to say is that if you think it's something worth your time, I would say go ahead and pursue it, because for me, it's where I find myself the happiest.